Hi folks, and welcome back to part 10 of our XCOM 2 Let's Play campaign. We've got a couple of wounded people out at the moment, and we're on a bonus guerrilla ops mission, which is going to net us 186 supplies, which is perfect because we're very soon going to have magnetic weapons researched, and we want to upgrade our troops and spend loads of money doing that as soon as possible. So, a couple of changes to the squad. We've got Alexei Sololololov on his first mission, and he looks amazing. Let's see what he can do. We needed a grenadier because our traditional grenadier Mora is injured, and we've also got Leo Kant, and he's a specialist. So we've got two squaddies on the roster. The rest of them are sergeants, lieutenants, etc. So let's get going and take it down. So it's a moderate difficulty mission, which means we can expect more than the usual number of squads, possibly four squads.
Sky Ranger deployed.
In position for deployment.
Remote reconnaissance has picked up a weak advent signal, slowly moving through this area. We think it's one of their data vaults being transported by a truck. The target is vulnerable, and as far as we can tell, the data may be tied to the alien operation we recently detected. Take out any hostile forces protecting the vehicle. Secure the AO and recover the assets.
Alrighty.
Menace 1-5, we've got a bead on the Advent Data Vault near your position. Be advised, self-detonating charges are in place at the target. Move to disarm and extract the package before its contents are destroyed.
Roger that, Central. Okay, so 8 turns, we're in concealment. We've got to get to this thing, and we have to recover the security information from there. Unfortunately, to do that, we're going to need to unlock it and then get eyes in there and then get in. So that's going to take us a little bit of time to do that. So it's not one of those missions where we can use our specialist to do a long range decryption or hack or something like that. The good news is that's one move, that's two. So it's kind of only kind of three yellow moves away. And we've got 8 turns, so we can not take our time because we've probably got extra pods here, but we can at least not have to charge double moves with every single thing that we do this turn.
Stay clear of those turrets. Oh, we're still not entirely sure if they're fully automated or remotely triggered.
My suspicion is that they are fully automated, Jen. So it's got 3 armor, which is huge, and 6 hit points, so yeah, and our hacker isn't necessarily the best since he's fresh from recruitment school, or fresh from the guerrilla tactics school anyway. His hacking trait won't be up there just yet, but he may still be able to disable it. There's no cover anywhere along here though. Well, let's have a look. How difficult is this for you? We don't necessarily have to do anything. 92% chance to shut it down. Wow. Okay, well, we can basically rely on that then. Let's not do it this turn, though. Hopefully that won't trigger it, will it? No. Good news. It hasn't even cost him an action. That's perfect. So let's move you up. I was going to say into some cover that's nearby, but there's nothing. There's literally nothing. Okay, well, let's move the rest of the team up. Hands, give us some eyes, please. He's going to spot something as well. Another one. Oh, it's perfectly reasonable. Wow, they obviously really want to protect this vehicle, don't they? We saw a Viper up here, plus a couple of other people. I think it was a Stun Lancer. All right, I want to keep moving. Let's go, team.
Running out.
Dasher.
Sinead, you're becoming more of a becoming more of a gunslinger for us, but still, you can move up to there into a nice little perch and allow Sergei to take that spot. That would be nice. Leo, I think just chill there is going to be the best thing, because then you can deactivate that soon. I wish there was a better bit of cover around here. A bit of cover.
Oh no! Utons seem a little more agile than the ones we fought in the past. It looks like they're still serving as the aliens' front line, though.
Oh dear, this difficulty moderate, I think, is possibly a slight understatement. We've got we may still have three pods because we've seen a Viper and we've now seen a Mutant, so the actual value of the targets is quite high. Plus, there's two of these guys. Oh my goodness, this is quite tricky. All right, who's got eyes on that Mutant? Where's Leo gone? Come here, Leo. All right, nice. So you can see the turret. An advent sentry. So we've learned that these guys can shoot or move and overwatch. I think they can take a double move and still overwatch, or they can shoot and overwatch. One of the two. There's that Muton. Oh, it'd be so nice if we could control that turret, but we can't rely on that at all. Okay, I think we're going to have to initiate by grenading the Muton. Why is there no cover here? Okay, alright, so we need hands to go up and do some more scouting for us. Oh, there's nowhere safe to go. Alright, go out a little wider, please, hands. What I'm hoping to see is that there's not another pod. Okay. So, this is going to be good information. What I want to do is I want to move Alexei forward to here and hopefully not trigger that pod, and be able to grenade the Muton and buddies. But that is triggering. That isn't triggering. But there's this heavy cover in the way here. So I'm not sure that's going to be a good line of sight for the grenade. It could work. That really could work, you know. By the skin of our teeth. Let's move up and try it. No harm in trying. Alright, lovely. As we saw before, the gas grenade combined with this amazing special grenade launcher that we've got, which I've equipped Alexei with in the absence of Mora, has shredded for two in the past with the gas grenade. So let's do that. That's going to be the move for us, I think. But I do want to make sure we can get some other shots off on that target. We are really suffering, though, because of this lack of cover around here. Really, it's not good for us at all. Can we take that spot there? No, that's not safe. Oh, it's just a bit dodgy. Oh, my. There's no cover in any of this area, which is exactly where we need to be to get some nice line of sight on that bunch. You know what? I've changed my mind. I think we're going to not initiate this turn. It's too risky, really. It just is too risky. Alright, so one of us is going to have to move up, please. You could do it, Aiden. Open the gate. That's going to allow us to stealth out of that gate on the next turn. We can take up a position there. Sergei, you can go there.
Oh,
no. And then we're going to initiate next turn, which isn't good for the timer ticker, but it's okay from the perspective of allowing us a better position, which I think is what we really need it. Yeah, Sinead, you can move to there, which does give you view over that way a bit more and that way. So, now look, she's now can see four targets, so that's good. Alright, and you can steady weapon as well, please. Let's see what happens on the alien turn. Alright, they're coming this way, which is kind of helpful for us. We've got a huge amount to deal with in this coming turn. Oh, they're on the move. At least they're not coming closer. That's going to be really important for us, actually. Yeah, great. Now, even so that means this whole car here is safe to move to without triggering that pod over there. So, as before, we're probably going to initiate with the gas grenade, which will get all of those four targets. Hopefully, Leo is going to be able to deal with that, which would be excellent. That leaves the rest of us to do something interesting and or important. Aiden's now got improved crit chance. Close combat specialist. But I'm going to put you on Overwatch. Aiden. Alexi, you're going to be initiating the fight. Now, you can't move around there, which is a shame. Can you move around? No. Is that half cover there? No. Alright, sadly, Alexi's kind of pinned. Alright, so we're going to have to not do a full Overwatch trap, which is something that you know I like to do. But we are going to have to just launch the gas grenade and then take it as it comes from there. We've got a few people on Overwatch, well, a couple of people on Overwatch, and then we've got quite a few people who can still take actions. That's great, a good amount of shredding. Bit of Overwatch to come. Oh, I'm so scared of that Muton. Look at the size of that gun. Oh, shit. Yes, hello. Oh, wow. So the same thing has happened again this time. Because they're in a gas grenade. We saw this on the mission before last. When they're in a gas grenade, the squad often don't want to run through it because presumably it's because they're going to take additional damage from that. But what is good about that is it means we can get further hits in on those guys. Alright, so it's important that we haywire protocol this thing. Come on, Leo. This is the first thing you've had to do in the entire game so far, buddy. So let's hope it goes well. 92%. Let's go. Boom. Smashed it. Well played, sir. That'll do. Hello.
Got it.
Shut down for two turns. Okay, so this is turn one. There's one more turn of shutdown to occur. Wonderfully, we've got lightning hands on good old Sinead. Let's rocketeer. Let's go and have a look at that guy. Oh, I don't like the sound of that. Not one little bit. So that's an advent rocketeer. He doesn't appear to have any additional guns, grenades, or weapons, but he could have a special kind of assault rifle which has got a grenade launcher attached or something. Either way, I don't like the sound of him at all. Our sentry, is that a sentry, isn't it? At the front there. Let's have a look. Yeah, the sentry has only got 2 health left and he's poisoned, so there's a reasonably good chance that he's going to die. So let's take our lightning hand shot at the rocketeer.
How many is that now?
Sinead, you're amazing. I don't know, really. I think it's about 8. Memory serves. And then you can take a shot. I'm thinking on the Muton for a 50% crit. Right, let's see who else we've got here. I want to take out this cluster of 4 so much that I'm prepared to reveal hands if we need to. He just does so much damage with his Hunter's Instinct on flanked enemies. That it's wonderful. Hunter's instincts plus 15. I thought it was only plus 10. Yeah. Oh, sorry. Plus 15. Oops, I'm confused about that. That doesn't seem to be all adding up. Oh well, whatevs. I think that we're going to want you to take a shot at the Muton because you might well finish it off. Let's see who else we've got. Spike. And move up. Yeah, why don't you move up, please, Sergei? Sergei, of course, has got holo targeting as well. Well, as executioner. So, we've got Sergei, we've got Hans, we've got Sinead. There's only three people, and we need to take down three targets, so that's a tall order. Yeah, we are going to have to use Hans. And we're going to use Hans. He's going to apply holo targeting and possibly just kill this thing outright. If we're lucky. Oh my goodness. Hans is becoming such a hero.
Ziel neutralisiert. Ziel objektige
Sicherheit. Yep. Okay then. We need to start putting some shots down on this advent turret. Oh, we missed the 82.
Oh, come on.
No. All right, we're going to have to suppress then in that case, which is annoying. Let's just have a look. We've got a 79% chance with Sergei. But to only deal 4 to 6 damage. And even if we could only kill it if we did 6 damage, we've got a 0% chance of crit. So actually what we need to do here is we need to suppress the turret. I hoped he was going to die there. Oh, this could be bad. This could be really bad. Looks like is he going to move? What's he thinking? Just chilling. Oh, you missed the suppression shot. Oh, he's overwatched. Oh, wow. Don't set that thing on fire. Oh, I hate standing. What's going on? Oh, my heart is racing so bad. Right, okay, let's just take stock very slightly here. Alright, we need to destroy that turret this turn because this is the last turn that we've got. That guy's on one health, so if we could just hit it. In fact, I was about to say, in fact, he's going to die because he's poisoned, but the clever bastard has put himself on Overwatch, which means we need to kill him in our turn and not wait for the gas to kill him if we want to move, and we definitely want to move this turn. So maybe, Alexi, what are you saying? 669, yeah, let's try that. Oh my god, he's got covering fire. Shit. Well, luckily he was still had poison on him, which was giving him a reduced aim, but the fact that he had, I mean, was that flanking? No, it wasn't flanking, but he had height advantage, he was very close, and I feel quite lucky that that shot didn't connect. 25% chance to crit, not bad, and it will apply holo targeting too, so let's take that. That's nice damage, buddy. We want to get out as usual to go and collect that juicy loot. Nice. Right.
You want some more?
So we've only got three people left here.
Moving on target location.
The first one we're going to take is with Sergei. Is Sergei in cover at the moment? Not in any kind of cover. Okay, so we do need to make sure he's in cover against this thing. We'll pop in there. Now hit it for 90 and put some holo targeting on. Yep, we did put on holo targeting. That's good. Now, Aiden, I'm a bit concerned that we may not be able to take this thing down. We'll use flesh on it. 100% chance to hit for 5 to 7 damage. But going right that far forward is actually quite a lot further forward than our current troops, so I'm worried about triggering another pod because that would suck right now. So I think that we're probably going to go here and just take a shot.
I'm on it.
Just to be safe. 100% chance to hit 4 to 6 damage. Please let me fall. Oh, you hero.
Went off the armor.
All right, it's nearly dead. This is the special Knuckles assault rifle, so it does additional damage. 3 to 6. Don't do 3, please, bud. Come on, Leo. That's exactly what we needed. Alright, hopefully they're not going to walk in on us this turn. No, no. We wanted to reload an Overwatch, but still, we can't complain too much. Okay, we've got a Viper. We've got 2 Advent. Let's have a little look at what they are. Advent Gunner, who's got a heavy weapon. It's got a heavy magnetic weapon. And just a regular old Trooper. Okay. So, what have we got to deal with this? We've got, of course, as usual. See, forgive me for taking a second. I'm not sure whether or not these turrets count towards the difficulty of the map. So we've got a moderate difficulty map. Oh, bollocks. If we want to pick up that loot, we've got to go into the bloody poison. Sorry, I've just got a bit of sidetrack. Let's check. Where's Hans? He got a healer. Got revive protocol, so he hasn't got any healing. He does have a med kit on him, but he has to go right up. Yeah, you can see there that it's only local to him because he doesn't have the healing perk. All right, it's probably gonna be grenade these two out of cover. Okay, I think a plan is coming together here. I did upgrade a couple of things I didn't mention before the mission began. I did upgrade Sergei's gun to have an autoloader on it, which is amazing. Which means that we can reload now for free. So let's take that. I want to go here and take a flank, but that is not a flank. Still, we know what a nutter Hans is. He could run up to that. Get a 20% chance of crit. 9 to 11 damage, that's nice. Oh, I'm tempted to take that. Very tempted. What's the worst that can happen? Well, we could trigger another pod. We probably don't need to do that. So if we don't need to do it, we won't do it. What we're going to do instead... Alright, we're going to take some position. Get people up, move them in a little. And then...
Headed there now.
Yeah, so Leo's basically out of the fight this turn. Alexei, if you could please do the business there. We need you to block those two rocks, do a bit of damage to the Viper, and leave them both without cover. That's great. So you can finish off the trooper, hopefully. Sergei. Oh, what a shame you can't hollow targeting both of them. Not sure why. Did I move him already? Happened there.
Maybe he reloaded. Moving to position.
So if you could take a run and gun to there, please, mate. Yep, 77. Redial dodge. Jeez.
Just a little off.
Who doesn't hate these Vipers? Honestly, they're such twats. Yeah, take it down, please, Sergei. 2 damage! 2 damage! we're actually in trouble now. We are in trouble. We can no longer finish them all off. It's bold. It's potentially a bit crazy. But it's killed that heavy guy. What else we triggered? Nothing. Nice. So the question is really, which is the most dangerous of those two targets? It's got to be the Viper, so let's finish the Viper off. I just was saving Sinead's shot for that standard Advent Trooper. And now I'm gutted. The only chance that we've got here really is that we put Leo on Overwatch and this guy runs for cover somewhere into his Overwatch. So we'll try that. He's gonna go a different way though, isn't he? Yeah, he's running towards the last pod on the map, hopefully. Hopefully the last pod. Oh, I lost the loot. Oh well. Okay, well that wasn't the end of the world. I thought we were gonna take some damage there. Alright, get a reload, please. Keep moving up. Keep things moving, team.
Affirmative.
Oh, that's a shame. There's nowhere Alexei can go that's in kind of half cover and can still get shot. Oh, we'll just move on up into full cover somewhere. That's frustrating. Oh, well.
За дело.
And I want you to start catching up with the rest of the team, please, Sinead. Oh, you got a shot on him. Only a 34% of those. But suppress him instead. How about that? Yeah. And then Duke.
On in motion, you wish on yet. Got it covered.
And let's take a reload and then just Overwatch for us, please. I don't want to move up any further this turn. Still running. Get him, get him, get him. Yeah. Come on, Sergei. That's the shit, buddy. Promotion. Oh, okay, this isn't going too dreadfully. Despite the difficulty there at the beginning. Not too bad. Should be able to hack the back of that door now. We can. No? What the hell? We've really got to get that open. How did he not see that? All right, this is getting pretty urgent now. We've only got two turns left here. And who's going to take the bold move forward for us? It's going to be you, Hans, isn't it? Okay. What can you see if you move up to here? Nothing, okay. That reload definitely isn't free. Well, let's take a look at what the hat is on this thing anyway. Might be something useful. Okay. Do you know, I quite like the look of that. Gain control of a random enemy for two turns. That's super cool. 50-50 chance on all enemies gaining a defense and mobility boost. Since we've taken down a lot of the bad enemies on this, there's a reasonably good chance that that might not be too bad for us if we fail that. So we can definitely go for that next turn, but for now, let's just get people going, moving up. Overwatch with you, Sergei. Duke, there's literally no cover. So why don't you just creep up a little bit?
I'm on it.
Go some Overwatch, please, Aiden. No, Overwatch.
On Overwatch.
Alright. Open that door.
Augen auf das Ziel.
Menace 1-5, this is Avenger. We have positive confirmation of the target package. Move to acquire.
Okay, so slightly unusually, you didn't have to hack the back door, you just had to open it. And now we've got to kind of, you know, hack, inverted commas, that thing in order to make it happen. But of course, what's cool here is Leo is in range. He should be able to get it from here. He can.
Accessing system.
Let's see what this thing is saying. Please be a bonus to hacking skill, please. Oh, he's only got a 50% chance. Okay, cross fingers. Here we go. No, no. Oh, boo. You know that Dave would have been able to do that, no trouble, right? She's sadly wounded this mission.
Piece of cake.
Piece of cake. Do exactly what we wanted you to do there, bud.
The charges are inactive and the package is secure. Eliminate any remaining hostiles near the AO.
All right, we're not in a rush now. There might only be that one person left, but the way he ran off does make me think that there's probably some other group back there. So I'm going to move everybody up to the same kind of point, and then next turn we're going to push forward aggressively. I'm going to charge on in. Gonna be glorious.
Getting it done.
Yeah, just chill there, please.
Bestätigt. Überwachung läuft.
Oh, here they come.
We've got advent here.
No one fancies Overwatch. Okay. I'm loving the diverse advent squads. All right, who's got eyes on these boys? No one really. Okay. I want to find out what they are. What sorts of advent are they? Oh, that looks good. Let's go, Sergei. If you wouldn't mind opening the door, please, sir. Jolly good. So we've got an advent rocketeer again. So the rocketeers are orange looking. An advent gunner. And an advent sentry. The sentries are always blue. How is he? Greenish, I guess? Alright, I really want to have a bit of fun here on this last turn.
On the move.
I want to do as much crazy maneuvers and flanking as possible. Oh, your flesh is only up to there. Shame. Where's your blue move to, Sonny? Over to there. Okay, so you got a flush to there, that's cool. Alexi, what you got going on, mate? Where's the cover that guy's got? Where's that rock there? So you need to move in over. Okay, I think I've got a plan coming together.
Приказ ясен.
Here we go. Only 69 and not necessarily going to kill him. So 75% put the hollow target in there. That's nice. Now we're going to follow up with Mr. Solid. Finish him off. Lovely. Following up with a run and gun attack.
Running and gunning.
Running and gunning.
Got it. Moving.
Not very English for a Scotsman. Nevertheless, he's still got a big fat gun. Hello, buddy. See you later.
X-ray neutralized.
Yeah, so we've got a bunch of options now for dealing with this last guy. Sinead missed?
Come on, focus.
What are you thinking, Sinead? Oh, it's not your day, is it?
Shot wide.
Oh, well. We're just going to have to let Hans deal with the situation. Yeah. Eek attack.
Feel eliminated.
That's status the end, confirmed. Right? Lovely.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
Crushed it.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Well done, team. Not the best face you got going on there, Sinead. Still, that was a real result. Now that's going to give us the supply.
Up the score, Commander.
One by one. Work out there. Thanks very much. Sergei, 16 kills. That's an average of 2 kills per level. Hans, despite being concealed most of the time, he's got 19 kills. What a legend. Doing really well here, gang. I love how happy Leo is. He's just fucking buzzing it. Absolutely buzzing it. We've got a repeater. And at last. Oh, praise Glob. We have a stock. So we've got somebody now who can deal guaranteed damage to something. Neutron autopsy, that's going to be very important for us. And an advent turret breakdown of the surge. 186 supplies, 5 days till magnetic weapons. Oh, this, you know, I'm pumped. I'm frothing with excitement. Intel to be had. Intel to be had. I'm going to ignore the special forces, the soldier that we were looking for, I think. That we could go and look for, rather. I'm going to go straight for the intel.
Avenger plotting new course.
How much cash we got now? 357 supplies, which is great. And we've got another supply drop in 3 days. Daniel's going to be retrained any second. Here he comes. That's fine. We'll carry on.
Message coming through.
Resistance
Commander.
Con monthly report.
I had high hopes for the resistance under your leadership, Commander, and you have outdone yourself.
Oh yeah, there's a lot of red stuff here. all progress on the Avatar project. If we can expect that every month, it's going to be pretty tough for us. Alien facilities constructed, 1. Dark events completed, 2. So none of that's good, but we did do very well. And we've now got new staff available, including a corporal. Oh, Sophia Bogdanova. Oh, and a doctor of some sort. So we'll go and check them out. And 177 supplies. New alien facility in a week. At least the next retaliation strike isn't for 5 weeks, so that's kind of cool. We don't really want that minor breakthrough. We definitely don't want that, because this month I'm really hoping to start pushing out and getting into contact with some other people. Although neither of those are really horrific. Let's go and get that supplies right now.
Avenger plotting new course.
Because we've got magnetic weapons arriving any second now. Beautiful. Yeah, let's go and have a little look over there.
Course for Sector 14, East Asia.
Welcome, Commander.
Okay, so we've got a scientist. Oh, a ranger, a corporal level ranger. That's quite cool. And I like Sophia. She's been part of my squad in the past. She's done a very good, very, very good job for me. Straightforward and really get stuck in. Let's keep going with the intel. I don't think I want to spend money on anyone with the magnetic weapons just around the corner.
I could have predicted this outcome, though it is intriguing.
So intriguing, Tiger.
Magnetic-based weapons are a lot like the early railgun prototypes. They fire projectiles at extremely high velocity.
Beautiful. She looks so smarmy about that. Oh yeah, check out these magnetic weapons we've just made. Good work there, Shen. Very good work. So we've now unlocked magnetic rifle, the shard gun, the mag pistol, which is cool, and stutter mag. Now we can also research gauss weapons. I want to do gauss weapons very quickly. So this is the equivalent of the SMG. Mag pistol, upgrade to the pistol. Shard gun is an upgrade to shotgun. And the magnetic rifle is an upgrade to the assault rifle. So that's all wonderful stuff. We do still need to upgrade to research the gauss weapons, which is going to give us the heavy weapon version and also the sniper rifle version. Advanced stun lancer autopsy is now instant, so we're going to go ahead and do that straight away since it's going to take no time at all.
The Advent Stun Lancer was apparently outfitted with the intention of serving as a civilian peacekeeping unit within the city centers. Although they are equipped with weapons capable of administering non-lethal blows, recent reports indicate an increasingly aggressive stance taken by these units. Although Advent clearly intended for these units to be their means of dealing with any unruly civilians within the
city. And we've now unlocked the Arc Blade 2.
It seems they have come to rely on more brutal means of pacification in the time since.
Yeah, it's not very nice of them, is it? Wow, we've got a whole bunch of stuff here on the research tree. Alright, so I do want to push for gauss weapons as soon as possible. And then we can start going towards hybrid materials and getting some extra armor, which is really, really awesome and so important. It's going to do not just extra protection for us, but it's going to give us a huge amount more versatility, and I can't wait to get that. I mean, this is apart from magnetic weapons being great, I almost prefer the armor because of the new options it unlocks for flexibility within the squad, and I'll talk about that more later on. And then from there, possibly jumping into resistance radio, but I want to get sectoid autopsy and psionics going ASAP after that. At this point in the game, there's just so many important things that we need to start doing. I mean, Mutant Corpse is really good, and I might even take a detour to get that. That gives us some really important stuff. I'm gonna have to take a bit of a think take a bit of a think. I am going to have a bit of a think.
Make that research a priority, Commander.
About how to proceed
the report is available.
And which way we need, because there's so many options here. There are different ways that we could go that are going to benefit us.
Prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander.
If a sniper rifle, Iron Maiden, increased mobility by 3 and decreased damage by 25. That's kind of cool. And with a repeater. Alright, not bad. That would probably be really good if we hadn't retrained. And actually, that might be fine to equip with our on our gunslinger. Yeah, I don't think that's the best though. That would be really good on some other weapons, but not so much on a sniper rifle, sadly. Oh well.
I await your orders.
That's the luck of the draw, I guess. Oh, mutanopsy, autopsy, viper autopsy. These are all good. 14 days for Gauss weapons. Just quickly double check mutant autopsy. As I mentioned before, this little button here, tech tree, is thanks to a mod. And it's, as you can see, amazing. It's got all the details. Where's Muton? Yeah, Muton autopsy gives us advanced grenade launcher, which is amazing. I think we're gonna, okay, we're gonna take a little detour. We're gonna get Muton autopsy.
Central Officer Bradford has personally substantiated claims that the massive frontline unit they call the Muton was actually at one time even larger than the specimen I have before me today. As it is, the creature is abnormally warm to the touch for a corpse, and I must say, it is quite disconcerting.
It's Tigan pretending that he cares about like dismembering warm things. I don't believe that for a second.
Advent has made steady progress in convincing the remaining civilian populace to migrate to their city.
Sorry to interrupt you there, Ricky. Whew, got a ranger now. Ochimbikani is ready. Nice. What we're going to do actually is go and put another one in the training straight away. We've got to get a ranger up to speed ASAP. Where would I? Yeah, that's right. Guerrilla Tactics School. Turn up a new rookie. And as promised, it's Aaron Johnson next. So we've got quite a few assaults. 2 grenadiers only. 2 specialists only. 2 rangers. A gunner. No, be specialist. I think I'm going to make her another grenadier. Okay, well, let's quickly pop down to engineering. Hey, Shen. And build our wonderful new weaponry. Luckily, well, not luckily, by design, really, we've saved up 535 supplies. 34 supplies. So we're going to upgrade a whole squad with a bunch of cool stuff. Oh, we are limited, unfortunately, by the amount of alien alloys that we've got, though. So let's get for sure the magnetic shard gun first of all, and magnetic rifle. That only leaves us with 12, but luckily that's enough to get the mag pistol. Well, that worked out really well. It'd be nice to get the arc blade as well, but that's coming pretty soon. We just need to get some more allies in. We could do with another. We could do with another supply mission. Centers,
I've never actually had one of these Advent burgers I keep hearing rumors about.
Yeah, they don't come recommended. So, Central, if you could please start scanning and keeping your eyes out for another supply mission, that would be great. Check in with the resistance contact. We need to find a spot we can go in and rob.
Commander, the aliens have made significant progress toward their goals.
Uh-oh.
New Advent facilities are cropping up around the world.
Operation Swamp Walk. Okay. Thanks, Central. That's not cool. Oh dear.
Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
We're planning on just that. Alright, we're basically done on this.
Strategic resource located.
56 intel, lovely. Life signs. On closer inspection, we discovered a badly wounded sectoid tucked away in the ruins of an old building. After a limited interrogation, the sectoid expired. We did manage to get some new information out of it first, though. Nice! Oh, Valen would be so proud of us. Okay, team. I think it is time to finish off investigating this mission, this signal. Checking. No, let's do it. Here we go.
Plotting new course.
Oh, I've been waiting for this. So excited. What is this encrypted signal? Oh, no. Okay, I'm always happy to see Gorilla Ops, but that was like within a half an hour of us figuring out where that was. All right, let's check it. Operation Doomwagon. It's going to be a moderately difficult mission to hack the hidden resistance computer to get 158 supplies and counter hidden event. That could be good. This is a lot further away, but it's going to be neutralize an advent VIP on tour. It's a difficult mission that counters the Avatar Project minor breakthrough. And gives us a scientist. We've got loads of scientists at the moment, I feel. And I quite fancy the supplies, and we don't know what the hidden event is. And also, this is closer to our current position. And I like the sound of Operation Doomwagon as well. Oh, that one's called Demon Hero. Oh, what great names we've got. All right. Operation Doomwagon, I think, is going to be the choice for us. One thing I am going to do before we double check that, if these things time out within 24 hours, and this is clearly so less than one day, it's probably just like 3 or 4 hours actually. What I want to do is have a quick look around to see how hard it's going to be for us to make contact with some of these places. So what we want to do is push into New Indonesia, which is going to then unlock this region of Australia and then give us access to take down that alien facility there in Australia. But in order to do that, we're going to need to spend intel, which we've got 200 or so of already. But that's going to be the next... Oops, that's the wrong button. That's going to be the next step. As much as actually, now I think about it, I can unlock that. I don't know if that's going to trigger all sorts of stuff off, that, which might take time. I'm going to be going into that completely blind. So let's go and do this gorilla op first. And we are going to do the local one in New
Setting
India.
Setting course for the Indian Regional Zone.
Okay, so as always, I'm going to leave it here. I will catch you back for part 11. Thanks so much for watching. I'm having such an awesome time. I hope you're all enjoying it too. See you again soon.